Ladies and gentlemen, we now move on to the fourth fight of this evening, which is an amateur featherweight contest. This fight is brought to you by Body Fuel Belfast. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, representing Coopers, weighing in at 65.8 kgs, it's Kian Devine. Introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, representing Yodha, weighing in at 66.3 kgs, it's Peter McErlean.
Ladies and gentlemen, our third mixed martial arts bout of the evening sees Kian Devine of Coopers MMA Navin taking on Peter McErlean of Yoda MMA Mara Felt. Third man in the cage is the best in the business, Mr. Dickie Larkin. Peter opens up heavy with kicks and in on a beautiful flare double. It'll be interesting to see what Peter's ground game's like. Obviously training under Ryan Roddy himself was a fantastic ground fighter, if anyone remembers.
Well, Phil, I've heard now from a good source that Peter comes from a great jiu-jitsu background, and I've heard now that he's a wizard on the ground, so it'll be interesting to see.
He established the mount seamlessly there, sinking in the grapevines. So you can already see that he knows the particulars of the positions he's in right now. He's just rolling the wrist beautifully. Not so much preoccupied with the striking right now. You can see him really just focusing on the position, which I like to see. He's not being frenetic. He's taking his time. He's being methodical, almost as if he's going through a sequence that he's practiced in training.
Definitely conserving a lot of energy as well, doing that process, as you say.
You can see any time that Kian tries to get rid of those hooks, you can see he just drops the hips a little bit, establishes the position, gets those grapevines back in. Very intelligent groundwork from Peter McErlean right now. Maybe this may be his amateur mixed martial arts debut, but he does have experience at inter-club level, has gone about it the right way, has entered grappling tournaments. Very nice to see. And you may have noticed that the shin guards are off now, moving forward, as these gentlemen are a little bit older. Now moving into the high mount. Still keeping the pressure down on those hips. Kian needs to be wary of what he's doing with those arms. If you leave your arms flailing when you're mounted, you're essentially gifting it to your opponent for an armbar. So he needs to be very careful what he's doing with his arms. He's doing the right things by bucking and getting the hips up, but what I want to see from him is trying to get the hips out a little bit as well, instead of just up with the hips, up and out, almost like a shrimping motion. But that's a lot easier said than done, because I'm not the one with Peter McErlean on top of me here.
Peter's defending very well. He isn't receiving much damage from Peter, but as you said previously, that
Peter is methodical in his work, and he is clearly looking perhaps for a submission.
I'd like to see him land a couple more strikes, as you say, just to set up that submission. Essentially, at this stage, it's theatricality and misdeception. You're landing the strikes to open up the submission. But you can see Kane always trying, always, he's not just flat backing and absorbing the strikes. You can see he's getting the hips up. He's trying to wrap a leg around. He's trying to use his dexterity to do something. But now Peter, obviously feeling more confident, is landing big strikes.
Perhaps at the wrong time in the round, Phil, with the final 10 seconds. Maybe if he had done it a bit sooner, he could have got a bit more joy.
Or potentially to leave an exclamation point in the round in the eyes of the judges. So it could go one way or the other, but a very dominant first round for Peter McErlean moving into round two.
Second round, let's hear it for both fighters, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm sure that Keith Cooper in the corner of Kane Devine has told him to be wary of the takedown. I think we now know the game plan of Peter McErlean is to use his strikes to close distance, secure the takedown, and then a dominant position. So I'd like to see Kane on the bike a little bit more, not standing square in front. And there's that takedown again from Peter McErlean.
Beautiful, just as in the first round, Phil, he got the takedown early on.
And you can see he's as soon as he had the legs out, he triangled the legs. Very intelligent. Again, illustrating just how meticulous he is, how much he pays attention to detail. Scores a beautiful trip off the double underhooks. Kane needs to be careful not to give up the back here. Peter just trying to sneak that arm underneath the neck. Has one hook in. If he can just slide around a little bit more. Kane now in the open guard of Peter McErlean.
Kane done well to improve that position for himself there, especially after the last round where I would say he got dominated on the ground from Peter.
Kane trying to step over into that very low mount position, trying to suck those legs out from Peter McErlean and pull him off the cage, because right now Peter has that cage up against his back and he's using it as an extra post from which to get up, and does so beautifully. Peter up, landing big strikes. Watch out for a 1-2 or a 1-2-3 from Peter McErlean to set up another takedown.
It'll be interesting to see if Peter's stand-up is as good as his work on the ground.
Interesting. Kane Devine instigating the clinch. Peter with a heavy overhook. Just trying to pump that down with the whizzer. Both men trying to establish the double underhook position. Good bicep control, but a knee very close to the head there from Kane. Peter again in on a beautiful double leg.
That double leg served him so well in this fight, as he looks to once again dominate on top.
This potential.
Kane Devine.
Kane with the overhook may try and use that to sweep, but it's very difficult for him to do that in this position where he's compressed against the cage. So. But manages to get back to his feet. Peter trying to establish those double underhooks. May look to trip here. Nice knee to the body from Devine. But again, that double leg. Kane just, he hasn't had an answer for it yet. And as we know, in mixed martial arts, especially amateur mixed martial arts, takedowns score so big.
Peter has definitely been relentless with that takedown. Kane, though,
full credit to Devine. Every time he's been in that position, he's tirelessly worked to try and get out of it.
Especially in this round. Perhaps not so much in the last round, where he maybe failed to be able to get up onto his feet, but definitely in this round, he's fought well to get back up.
So regardless, yes, he's been taken down twice in this round, but he's also gotten back up. So that's bound to give him confidence moving in to the third and final round.
It's actually a good fight from from a different perspective.
Third and final round, let's hear it for both fighters, ladies and gentlemen.
I'll tell you what, Glenn Irvine and Aaron Wallace working on behalf of the commission here. If they tell you to get out of the cage, you get out quick. Big double to open up from Cian Devine, flipping the script a little bit on Peter McErlean.
Perhaps a different approach to the third and final round from Cian.
Needs to be wary of the triangle here. You can see Peter just trying to grab that wrist, stuff it down, and then cross that leg across the shoulder blades. He may have it here. Beautifully. Oh, thought he had it momentarily. Done the right thing by underhooking the leg, but didn't quite have the purchase on it that he needed.
Peter scrambling. Well, Peter looking to scramble back up to his feet.
But again, may use the cage here. Cian doing the right thing by trying to take him off that cage just a little bit. Peter stuffing down that head. He's going to try and wall walk a little. I'd like to see Cian triangle those legs a little bit. But landing big strikes here in the third round.
Cian, for the first time in the fight, probably in a dominant position, would you say,
yeah,
Phil?
Yeah, he's trying to grab that ankle and almost ankle pick and take it away from Peter. But Peter does well to get to his feet. Needs to be wary of the guillotine here. But it's been a story of that double leg takedown for Peter McErlean. So intelligent with it, and he does the right thing. It's not just up and down. You can see him establishing it and getting the flare on the legs, and thus landing in a more advantageous position.
Really is beautiful, beautiful work from Peter. And what has been the story of the fight so far.
Yeah. He's now inside the half guard of Devine. May look to establish some shots here and finish strong in the third and final round. If he were able to get a finish in the third round, it really would be the cherry on top of a fantastic performance, just sneaking that leg through from the half guard to the mount.
Oh, Cian looking to scramble up.
Needs to be wary here of giving his back. Again, flare, double, almost cradles Devine there and sets him down. It real is just a clinic in wrestling and positional control, because yes, he may be young, only 24 years old, but he establishes the position before doing anything else with it. I really like to see this intelligent approach, and that stems from working under a coach like Ryan Roddy. Needs to get those hips just a little bit lower, but he's right in front of his corner now, and what a position to be in the final round. Landing big strikes.
Peter perhaps looking for the finish. That would top off a beautiful performance from himself.
Cian needs to be careful not to give the arm. 10 seconds. We may see just an explosion here from Peter, landing big strikes to try and get that finish. Finish strong. Beautiful fight. Absolutely wonderful fight. And a great performance from young Peter McErlean in his amateur mixed martial arts debut. Full credit to Cian Devine as well. He stayed in the fight for as long as possible. Lesser men would have been in positions like that and maybe given the arm to try and get out of the fight, but he stayed in for the duration and was constantly fighting. Fantastic fight from both men. Fantastic experience gained from both men. Now nothing left to do but send it up to the voice of Akuma Fighting Championship, Mr. Stuart Warren, for your official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, the judges have reached a decision, and the winner by unanimous decision, fighting under the red corner, it's Peter McErlean! Let's hear it for both fighters, ladies and gentlemen.